Turns out there is an Armenian dish, stuffed cabbage head, that I've never heard of, never tried. And the recipe got me very interested, so today we're gonna make it together. I'll taste it, we'll let you know how it tastes, and it's up to you, try it, whether to try it or not. Trust me, you will be very interested. So what you need is a medium to small cabbage head. And what I did with cabbage, I frosted it and then I defrosted it. You need to remove the leaves. And you will be starting with large leaves, going to just like the cabbage itself. You will be starting, let me give you, I'm so excited, I'm all like mixed up. I don't know from where to start. Cabbage, you need the cabbage, and then you also need a round bowl, deep bowl. This fabric, how do we call this one? You know this fabric that they sell it everywhere. I'll remember throughout this filming process. Cheesecloth. Okay, you need cheesecloth. And then I have mixed pounds of turkey and beef. The dish is originally made with beef. That's that, or lamb. Armenians have tons of recipes with lamb meat. And then you need an onion, of course, oil to fry those onions. Mm-hmm. That's that. Also, you need carrots that I'll be chopping. I already half cooked, barely cooked some round rice. Just pour some hot water over, bring it to a boil, turn off. You don't want to cook it all the way. So I have the rice, spices, seasonings. I'll go to my taste. I have black pepper, red pepper, cayenne. I have cumin, white pepper. I always use it because I love the flavor. And then also I have smoked paprika. It's not an important ingredient, but I had it, I'm gonna use it. For herbs, us Armenians, we love using dried herbs in our, this is basically some kind of tolma. It's just made in very original way. And I have dry basil that I dried myself with my own son. And then I have dry dill. You can use fresh ones just as well. And I have just a little bit of dry savory. In Armenian it's called citron. You can just Google it, and it's from rosemary family, but completely different and fragrant, very well matching with meats. The taste, it tastes very well with meats. That's that. And I'll also use some coriander and parsley. Salt, of course. Did I forget anything? I think no. Okay, let's see how this is made. So I'll go ahead, chop my onions, fry them, and then I'll add my garlic. No. Garlic, I forgot the garlic. I'll squeeze the garlic in between somewhere. I just like the garlic taste in general with meats. Oh, look at this carrot. Oh, it's a peace sign carrot. Okay, yes. So I'll fry the onions, chop my carrots, fry along with onions, and we'll go from there. I'm making everything to taste and by eyeballing, but of course I'll make sure to write a very detailed recipe. Onions are almost getting brown, but you don't want to brown them too much. You basically cook onions and carrots together. I'll add just a little bit of salt. And to this we'll be also adding fresh herbs after it's completely fried.
Half carrot.
You want sandwich?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on 1 minute. You want peanut sandwich? Peanut butter, yeah?
Carrot.
Oh, you want a carrot? I couldn't hear you. Here we go. Okay, so I'll turn the heat just a little bit down. Chop my herbs. Anything you have on hand will work just fine. Even fresh basil, fresh dill. course keep an eye on your frying things. Guys, you wanna come in? Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is here. The meats, I'll simply combine them in a bowl. Add my rice.
You want water? Anna, can you get your water by yourself?
No.
We need to learn to do a few things.
Water?
No.
Huh? What do you want? Uh-huh. Another person
around here.
You wanna mixy mix?
Wow.
Yeah, what you're eating? What you have in your mouth? It's a carrot? Oh, okay, it's a carrot. He eats the carrot this way in his mouth, like this. In this position. Here you go. Get the carrot. Yeah?
No.
Now this is done. That's it. Thank you. I'll add my herbs. Okay, the guy will mix it. You wanna mixy mix? Okay. You'll mixy mix garlic. I'll put the garlic in this mixture. Okay. Oops. Mixy mix. Okay. And let's mixy mix. Okay, because this is too hot now. And I'll go ahead and spice my meat and rice. Cayenne to taste. White pepper to taste. Black pepper, of course, salt, just like that, and then smoked paprika, any of your favorite meat spices, herbs, of course. We use good amount of herbs in our dishes, especially winter time, dry herbs are a must in our cuisine. This is dill, and this savory is the most fragrant herb you can ever use. This will go in there, and of course this mixy mix thingy. Onions, garlic, and carrots. Hold on, 1 minute. You're done with your job, okay?
Okay. Give me that.
Here you go, mix it. And I'll scrape this down very quickly. And I'll go ahead and add some water. Just to rinse this out, and also we usually make sure this kind of mixture, meat mixture for dolma, is kind of loose and a little bit like smooth. So some water. Okay, mixy mix. About half a cup or so. Preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Okay, I'll mix and taste the salt, and we'll go from there. It's almost ready. The mixture is ready. Or the filling. Okay, let me mix so I can taste the salt. We need more salt. And while the guy is mixing, I'll go ahead and separate the leaves. And what you want to do, you want to start with the larger ones, like
larger
this.
Larger
ones, yes. I think this is way too deep. Let me grab another bowl that's not too deep. And you will kind of layer all those large leaves first in your bowl. And then get the mixture and kind of spread it out, just like this, until you're done. Nice and even. And you basically continue doing the same thing until you're done. Layer the leaves, spread the meat, and finish. Okay, I'll do this one next. We're almost done. This may seem a little bit time-taking, but it's not really that difficult or way too time-taking. And at least it's worth the try. It's a new dish to me, which is very interesting. I thought I knew everything about my cuisine, but you live and learn. Each day I myself learn new things. A little bit more. Next layer, we're almost done. I'm getting to the end, to the last small parts of cabbage. I didn't measure anything, but apparently I have very good eyeballing skills. So this will be the last part. Almost done. I'll save this one. Just like so, and I'll add a little bit more on this side. And wait until you see the last part. This is here. Hajan. I don't know where the remote is, Arka. So here we go. You gather that cheesecloth ends, make it into a something like this, and squeeze it. As you squeeze, it will come together, just as like the original cabbage shape, just like this. Although my cabbage was this big. This is nice looking medium-sized cabbage. Okay, let's see if I can handle the hardest part, which is to remove this cabbage shape and place it onto a baking pan. So you'll gather the ends of cheesecloth and turn it very tightly. You want to make sure all those leaves and meat mixture come together tightly and properly. This is ready. And you need a baking pan. You can line it with something to avoid too much cleaning, or you can just leave it as is. And you need to place this cabbage onto a foil and gather the foil. It needs to bake covered with something. So what I did, I have the foil on the outside and parchment on the inside. Let me see if I can properly place this cabbage onto my parchment and cover it. Okay, so what I'll do, this is gonna be the hardest part. Whew. Just like this. So far so good. My foil wasn't probably big enough. It's still good. Not bad. But I want to make sure I don't have any leakage from, because I'm going to turn this upside down. Now this looks like a real foil cabbage. And this will bake about an hour 20 minutes, 350 degrees. I'll see you when it's done cooked or baked. This has been cooking exactly an hour and 20 minutes. At this point, you will take it out from oven, remove the covers, and it needs to bake another 20 minutes with open, without covers, I mean. You want to slightly brown the cabbage part. This looks exactly like normal cabbage. How cool does this look?
That's cool.
Right? This is a real cabbage. The second challenge will be to put this on a platter, but that's coming up.
What's the start date?
Start date?
Yeah.
We'll decide, okay? Give me 1 minute. I'll see you in 20 minutes.
love you, Beck.
I want to add a little for my
sister. Becca, did you say I love you too?
Yeah.
So I cooked an extra 30 minutes. I've been waiting for this to kind of brown, and I even brushed it with some oil, but apparently that oil made it kind of bubble. So don't do that. Oil will not help you. And you will need a proper platter. And let's see how we transfer it. Hopefully successful. Let's see. Most importantly, you wanna properly plate it. And I have some tomatoes. The dish is served with garlic yogurt. But before we serve it, I'm gonna slightly drizzle my tomatoes with the yogurt. I would also make some kind of tomato sauce to pour over the cabbage. You want Lucky?
Okay, okay.
Go with Lilith, okay? Okay, just like this. And then some herbs. Mm-hmm. I think this looks perfect. And let's now cut this thingy. Sharp knife. Let's hope it's cooked. Basically a cabbage cake. Smells so delicious. I'm gonna cut this so we see. I have some foil on the bottom, that's okay. You can always see and remove the foil. Look how gorgeous this looks. Some more herbs on the plate. And of course the garlic yogurt on top. Like this. And my cayenne will go last. It has to have some color. And this is the dish. And now let's try it. Let's see. This is probably the most beautiful looking cabbage dish I've ever made and tried. Mmm. It's so, so delicious. It's really good. A cracker, hold on, I'm trying a dish. You know, I would also have added some red bell peppers. See, when you look on the side, you see the carrot? The color will make it, colors between layers will make it look even more appetizing and more original. That's it, guys. This was probably one of the most delicious stuffed cabbage heads I've ever tried. So good. Mmm. And tomato goes very well with this garlic yogurt. Everything is just perfection. Thank you so much for watching. Try it. Very original dish for Thanksgiving. Probably you can make it with ground turkey only or just improvise. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon. So delicious. Cooked almost 2 hours.